the most notable investigation that we conducted was the World Trade Center collapse on 9/11. We needed to know how those fires progressed, how the fires heated up the structural steel, and eventually what was the collapse mechanism. We had to buy up samples of the various items that you would find in the World Trade Center. That was a time-consuming process. Not only do you need a database, a reliable place where you can get this information, as new materials are developed, you need to be able to readily measure these properties and get them into that database so that other people can use them.
The FSRI Materials and Products Database is a repository of material property data and fire test data. It allows us to elevate the baseline understanding and really the starting point for developing fire models and an understanding of fire dynamics.
This material database provides a single, easily accessible, and very well organized source where you can look up these properties for a wide range of materials that are particularly relevant to construction. These properties are very well defined, the methodology for their measurements is clearly delineated, and it's easy to access.
There's been a gap in material databases over the years with various materials tested at different labs and needing to grab properties for possibly different materials in modeling. The FSRI database is a great first step towards developing one cohesive database where the same materials were tested in similar configurations that will improve our ability to predict fire spread.
It's going to be extremely helpful to the investigators because obviously we're looking at all those materials that are in the home, all the furnishings, but the walls, the exterior, the roofing materials. It's just another thing to go to help you determine that origin and cause and come up with a great hypothesis of how that fire started.
I have a case that I'm involved in currently that I had some questions about the ignitability and the ignition temperatures of some products. And by going to the materials and products database, I was able to find that information and better formulate my opinions as to how that fire may have started. So having current information that we can look at in the field if we need to is a very valuable tool to the fire investigator.
As an independent research organization, we're committed not only to developing this, but also improving it and maintaining it. If you're a fire investigator, a fire modeler, a fire researcher, or fire protection engineer, I encourage you to go to the website materials.fsri.org